If you guys aren't as hype as I am, you're going to be, because I'm going to be showing you my very first 10-star light hero, GERKE. On top of that, I've made some audio adjustments to hopefully get a better sound quality for all of you. So let's get started. Before we get that 10-star GERKE, however, I need to level up my Lord Balrog to 9-star so I have some good fodder. While he's leveling up, I just want to say that I absolutely love the fusion and heroic miracle events. I was really hoping that they would be combined for this weekly event, but just having the fusion event helps me clean out all of my bags, all my heroes, because usually building up to this event, my bags start getting extremely full. I don't have any space for new heroes, and this is a great event to help clear out. I think I've made probably over 25 star heroes. I think 5 or 6 6 stars was able to awaken a few heroes. So we're cleaning out house. So this is without a doubt one of my top 5 best idle heroes moments ever. Not only is GERKE one of my favorite heroes, he's also my very first 10-star light or dark hero. I've put a ton of work into getting all the materials and fodder. I can't tell you how many profit orbs I've gone through just trying to get some light or dark 5-star heroes. So we finally made it, and here it is. That 10-star GERKE was just the beginning. During the last casino event, I always choose to spend what super casino chips I have. So as you'll see with that last roll, I was able to get 10 orange artifact shards, which is exactly what I needed to get another orange artifact. That is one of my major ways of progressing my team right now, is gear, artifacts, and guild tech points. So that orange artifact was massive, topping it off with a 5-star cruise. As you can see, I got the Echo of Death. I chose to put that artifact on my Demon Hunter because, as you'll see, it will grant a very, very nice crit and attack percent boost. So as you can see, I'm just going through. I have an insane amount of artifact fodder, I guess you'd say, to use to level these up to full strength. But as you can see, attack and crit boost. I've just been on a roll with priests today, and to continue the streak, I'm now going to take my Vesa from 8 to 9 stars. I still don't have 2 more copies of her to get her to 10 star, but I'm going to be working to definitely get her 10 stars as quickly as I can. I think she would be a major improvement over my Oramis, and who knows, I might even throw 3 priests and try to build up their guild tech tree. My luck has definitely been improving in 2018, but today has just been amazing. As you can see, I get 1 5 star, then 1, 2, 3 5 stars in one go. I don't think I've ever gotten more than 2. 3 on an official server, whoo! I literally pumped my fists up and down in the air a few times, if only you guys could see me. But as I'll go through, I continue to get a few more, as you can see, Lutz, a few more 5 stars. So I've been extremely happy with my progress and my luck with these heroic summons. As you can see, filling up my bags a little too quickly. However, I still am doing a lot of saving. I'm going to save those 2 5-star summons up at the top just in case. I have a feeling there's going to be a heroic miracle event coming up. And as you can see, I got the new hero Jara. Probably pronounced that wrong, I apologize. And I also got an Aiden, so I got both of the gear packages as well. So overall, a great heroic summon scroll event for me. So now that most of the hype is over and it's time to kind of calm down, I'm going to take this time while I'm leveling up some of my other heroes to discuss some of the changes that were made with the tavern, as well as some of the future changes that were hinted on their Facebook page. So starting with the tavern, I liked the idea of the autofill function, taking what heroes I had and optimizing which the fewest number that I needed to fulfill the requirements. However, I don't think it was as good of an idea to take out the might requirement, just because I thought it was really cool as I leveled up and got more and more high level heroes, I was able to complete and store more quests. So I was able to better prepare for the next tavern event by saving some of my heroes for those high level, high star quests. Now, I do understand, yes, it's going to be a lot easier to complete the event, which is very good, and I'm not complaining. It just took some of the fun away from it. Now, I can almost, or most likely can, with all the heroes I have, store up enough quests to basically complete the whole tavern event next time it rolls around. So I like how it's a little bit easier. I think the intention was good, but I think they could have executed it a little bit differently. But other than that, it's a decent change. So now, one of the changes I do really and am really looking forward to is the hero skin disassembly. So as I've been complaining before, I had three Demon Hunter skins, which I really only need one. Maybe one day I'll have more Demon Hunters on my team, but for now I'd rather have different skins. So I really love the idea of disassembling those skins. What I really hope they don't do is make it like two hero shards or three. I think that's a little low, and I know they might do that. So I'm really hoping you disassemble a skin, you at least get four or five of those universal hero skin shards. So another future change or addition is they're coming out with a new monster. So he looked pretty cool, looked like he's gonna be CC and freeze focused, which would combo great with Corpse Demon and Ice Blink most likely. However, I literally not too many weeks ago just finished an updated monster guide to include the snake and the golem, which were just added. So now I'm going to have everyone asking to do an updated guide. So what I'll probably do is just a single guide on the new monster when he or slash she or it comes out. But I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I hope you guys enjoyed my mic quality. So if you did, make sure to subscribe for more great content.